Hi dear students, today we are going to learn the second poem in the 12th English textbook. The name of the poem is Our Casuarina Tree, written by Toru Dutt. Our Casuarina Tree, written by Toru Dutt. Let's know about the poetess Toru Dutt. Toru Dutt was a Bengali poet from the Indian subcontinent who wrote in English and French. She was born in the year 1856 and died very young at the age of 21 in the year 1877. Her poems mainly focus on her Indian consciousness and her love towards Indian culture. The poem Our Casuarina Tree is an autobiographical poem. The poet recollects her pleasant childhood days with her brother Abju and her sister Aru, and the beautiful memories like how they played under the casuarina tree. Let's see how the name casuarina is derived. The name casuarina is derived from the name of a bird, cassowary bird, which is found in the tropical forest of New Guinea and northeastern Australia. Look at the hair of the cassowary bird. The casuarina tree also has spikes like the hair of the cassowary bird. And you can see red flowers on casuarina tree, and the cassowary bird has a red color on its neck. Have you seen that? Let's move on to the poem. In the first two stanzas, the poetess has given a detailed picture of the magnificence of the casuarina tree, or how big the casuarina tree is, or how gallant the casuarina tree is, described in the first two stanzas of the poem. In the third and fourth stanzas, the poet explains how dear the casuarina to her soul, how close the casuarina tree to her memory. In the final stanza, that is in the fifth stanza, the poetess immortalizes the casuarina tree through her poem. Now we can discuss the first two stanzas of the poem. In the first stanza, the poetess describes the casuarina tree as a very tall and strong tree with a creeper winding around it like a huge python or a big snake. That means on the casuarina tree, a creeper climbs like a big snake. The trunk of the tree is rugged and it has scars on its trunk because of the tight hold of the creeper. The creeper climbs up to the top of the tree, casuarina tree, as it can touch the stars or the sky. Let's think, if a creeper climbs on a tree, usually what will happen to that tree? Yes, you are right. If a creeper climbs on a tree, the tree loses its strength or it becomes very weak. But our casuarina tree stands gallantly or very bravely like a giant, and the giant wears the creeper as a scarf on its top. The creeper looks like a scarf on the top of the casuarina tree. The casuarina tree has flowers in crimson clusters. Crimson clusters. Do you know the meaning of the word crimson? Crimson means red. The casuarina tree has many red color flowers on its branches. And if we look at the casuarina tree, we can see that birds and bees gather on the tree. And at night, we can listen to the overflow of sweet songs from the casuarina tree. When people go for sleep, when men repose, when men go for rest at night time, we can listen to the beautiful songs from the casuarina tree. Some birds are singing from the casuarina tree. In the second stanza, the poetess describes that when she opens the casement, casement means window. When she opens the window in the early morning, that also in the winter season, she can see a grey baboon or a grey monkey sitting on the top or the crest of the casuarina tree like a statue alone. If we look at the monkey, we may feel that the monkey is watching the sunrise and its young ones are jumping and playing on the branches of the tree very happily. The poetess explains that she can listen to the beautiful singing of the kogalas from the casuarina tree. And listening to the song of the kogalas, the sleepy cows start grazing under the tree. In the winter season, the casuarina tree looks like a snow tree or a hoar tree with white frost deposits on the tree. And near the casuarina tree, there is a tank or a pond with water lilies, and the water lilies are decorated with the snow. This is the explanation of the first two stanzas. The remaining three stanzas we will discuss later. Thank you.